Hey everyone, today we're going to learn how to use states as a condition instead of using something like variables to keep track of what's been visited and what hasn't been visited inside of Articulate Storyline. So let's go ahead and get started. Welcome back. My name is Jeff Batt, and if you haven't checked out my website already, go ahead and check out my website at learningdojo.ninja. Here you can find all previous blog posts with tips and tricks on all kinds of e-learning development here. You can also go to templates and download Articulate Storyline 360 templates and XAPI templates. And you can find full courses if you're new to Articulate Storyline. You can find full courses on Articulate Storyline where you learn everything from A to Z, Adobe Captivate, XAPI Fundamentals, Articulate Rise, Custom SCORM, and HTML5 Video. I've seen oftentimes where a student wants to keep track if tabs have been visited and then show something if all the tabs have been visited, or have something pop up or go to the next page or something like that. Now, most of the time, I've seen people try to use variables to, like a true or false variable that's false to begin with, and they'd have to change it to true. And then if all of those are true, you can go ahead and go on to the next page or show this content. But there's an easier way inside of Articulate Storyline, and I'm going to show you how to do that. So let's go ahead and pull up Articulate Storyline. And I just have a sample tab interaction here, just a four simple tab interaction that shows some text over on the right-hand side. Now what I want to do is pop up a little character on the right hand side once they've visited all four items. Now these different buttons, if you go into the states, only have a normal state. I'm trying to keep it as simple as possible just so you can kind of understand what's going on, and then you can apply it inside of your own tab interaction, however, or whatever you've created. So I'm going to go ahead and insert a character, and I'm going to insert Laura. I found a pose already of Laura with a thumbs up, so I'm going to go ahead and click on insert here. Now you can change the pose by going into the character tools under design and clicking on pose. I'm going to resize this person so she's just kind of off the stage a little bit. I got asked this question just last week about one of my students, like, why do you always crop things that are off stage? The reason why is this right here, where you have this little scroll bar over on the right-hand side. Sometimes things may be off, sometimes they won't be, but just to play it safe, what I do, I don't like anything that's kind of hanging off the stage there. So I go ahead and just click on the crop button, and then I bring this up to the stage, which it kind of snaps into the stage right there. That's it. I don't like the floating people pictures where they're just kind of off in no man's land, but I like to have that just kind of crop towards the edge there. Now, what I'm going to do is select this person and then go ahead and select hidden here. I want her to be hidden to begin with. I can still see it, but she's kind of grayed out at this point. But I don't want the students to see it until they've met the criteria and they've visited all those different states. We have one more problem though, is this tab interaction doesn't have a visited state. So I need to create a visited state for all these different tabs. It's pretty easy. You just under the states, click on edit states, click on add a new state, and then go ahead and click on visited there. And if I click on add, it now has a visited state. So I can click on done. And I need to do the same thing for all four tabs. I can go into a tab, I can click on edit, and then I can add that and so forth. Or I can actually come in under the format painter, under the home tab actually, and double click on format painter, and now click on tab 2, tab 3, and tab 4. And it creates those states for me automatically. Now visited, you could have slightly darker in color, or you could just have it the same as a normal state, but that will just keep track if they have visited that tab or if they have not visited that tab. So that's something to keep in mind. Now, what I'm going to do here is I want this person to be visible if they have visited all four tabs. So I need to create a trigger. I also want this person to animate in from the right. And so I can add an animation with her selected here. I'm going to click on animation, click on fly in, and then I'm going to click on fly in from the right here. Now, when she comes in, it won't be at the very beginning of the timeline, but when she becomes visible, she'll fly in from the right. So that's one nice thing we can do there. Now, I'm going to go back in here, and I want her to show up as soon as all states have been visited. So we need to create a trigger, but the first part of this trigger is very important. The first part in any trigger is the action. What do you want to have happen? In our case, we want to change the state, but keep that in mind. Whenever you're adding triggers, you always want to first of all think about, what do I want to happen when this trigger fires? I'm going to come over here and select this drop-down box, and I'm going to change the state. We're going to change the state of this character, so character one right here. I would probably name her Laura just so it's a little bit more obvious of what it is. And I'm going to go into the when. When does this actually happen? So we have the action. Now we're going to have the when. When does this happen? Now the when is the state of. So we can do this based off of one state of an object. We can do it based off of several states of an object. And I'm going to go ahead and do this based off of the tab 1, tab 2, tab 3, and tab 4. So I could have other triggers where if tab 1 is visited or tab 2 is visited and no others, I can have like you're almost there kind of thing. Or I can even have like if you have them select several things and you can check to see if this has been visited, then you can show an alert message as well. So there's a lot of different possibilities here. I'm going to go ahead and select just off here and it will update here in a second that when all of these have been changed to the state of visited. It automatically selects that for me because that's the only state that they have in common. It will think through that automatically here. Now I don't need to add any other conditions. This is kind of a condition in the when section, but I'm not even working with conditions at this point. I'm just checking the states of the object. So I'm going to click OK. And that's really all that I have to do. So if I go ahead and preview this, I have already have the triggers to show layer 1, show layer 2, and so forth. So here's tab 1. You can see here, I'm going to go to tab 3. I'm going to go to tab 2. And then tab 4. Now one problem I did not actually name these tab 2 or tab 3. So let's go ahead and just do that real quick when I was setting this up. So it didn't look like the text was changing because I just have lorem ipsum in there. But let's try that one more time. All right, so tab 1, tab 2, there's my text changing, tab 3, and tab 4. Let's replay here and let's go in a different order. Tab 2, tab 1, tab 3, and tab 4. So it doesn't matter what order we go in. It will just keep track of once all of these have been visited, then trigger something else. Show a layer, go to a different page, or you know, submit a quiz question or something like that. It's pretty simple to be able to set up this way and to check the conditions of the states instead of actually having to create variables and keep track of those variables and adjust the variables and so forth. So I just wanted to show you that today, just a quick tip. Hopefully this was useful for you. If you wanted to check out more, go back to my website, learningdojo.ninja. Check out my blog of all different blog posts on Storyline, XAPI, Camtasia, other things like that. You can also check out templates on Articulate Storyline 360. You can check out courses, full courses on Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, XAPI Fundamentals, Articulate Rise, Custom SCORM, and HTML5 video. And if you like this video, go ahead and go to my YouTube channel and click that like button and subscribe to my channel and hit that bell notification so you get alerted when all new videos come out. That would really help my channel. And that's all that I have. So thanks everyone. I'll see you next time.